Despite the continued spike in cases, it seems more people are feeling comfortable planning trips these days, some even getting on airplanes.
Max Massey shows us what this pandemic has meant for our local airport and what precautions are in place to keep everyone safe.
And I'm comfortable on flying.
Bill Bean is one of the few people we saw headed onto a flight this morning.
We've raised American saddlebred horses for 40 years.
Bill and his wife are headed to Kentucky on an event they've been waiting months for. And walking around the San Antonio International Airport, it's almost bizarre at how empty it is. If you've never been here before, just a few months ago, it was very different.
2018, we surpassed 10 million passengers that year, which equated to an average of 30,000 passengers a day, about 15,000 inbound, 15,000 outbound.
Then the pandemic hit.
At the lowest point of the pandemic, we were down to just about 100, 200 passengers a day. So it impacted us very hard, about a 90%, 95% hit.
Because of the lack of customers, some flight schedules were changed, some were even stopped.
International flights were paused for a period of time, but they have now returned. You know, we're proud at SAT because we think we're the gateway to Mexico.
But now, months into this pandemic, there appears to be a glimmer of hope.
The month of June, we saw that we surpassed 4,000 passengers a day. So we continuously see that increase in passengers every day.
Along with the lack of passengers you see here at the airport, one thing that jumps out is the amount of precautions in place. There are these sanitation stations all around the airport.
There are also social distancing markers on the ground throughout the airport. You can't really look around without seeing a safety enhancement. As for Bill and his wife, they are ready and excited for their trip.
It's our time to show horses in our breed. Due to the virus, they've all been canceled. They're just now getting fired back up in Kentucky. This is the first opportunity for us to go.
Max Massey, KSAT 12 News.